Hi, in my last video, I told you that it would be a good idea to print my pictures, and to be quite honest, I already ordered some prints at this time. A bit of a disclaimer first. The printer, Saar Digital, posted an ad on Instagram and I applied for it. They were looking for photographers and wanted reviews of their latest product, the Professional Line Photobook. So I received a coupon code of 100 euros in order to make a review. And they wanted me to make an honest review, and that is exactly what I'm going to do here today. When it comes to ordering your prints, Saar Digital provides you with a variety of options, and I went for the easiest way, that is ordering from their dedicated software, which is a proprietary software. So you arrive here on the article selection, so I went for the photobook and then photobook professional line. I went for this particular size here. So first you choose the size and then you have some kind of options here. Some are free, others are not. And then you can move on to the design part. Here you can see that you can be guided or be free to do whatever you want. I will not bore you with all the details, don't worry, it will not be too long. Then you choose the number of pages. You can select pretty much any number of pages you want, and you can also change at any time. You can see on the bottom left here there is an add page and a delete page button. On the left here you have your file system to which you can fetch some pictures, and then you find them here. You can place your picture pretty much everywhere you want. You have a hint of image quality, which is the pixel ratio. If you try to put something that is way too large, the image quality will go from very good to good, and then it will go to poor, etc. If you don't have enough pixels to cover the page, I think that is a good idea for a beginner like me to have something like that. So here you can do pretty much whatever you want. Place your picture, resize it. You're free to do what you want. You can also add text here. You have some design ideas on the right. You are free. Then you add to cart, and there is a review kind of thing that allows you to see if you have missed out on something. Here, most of my pages are blank, and Saar warns me that I have blank pages. And then you place your order and you wait. And here, this is what I ended up with. I think it's a pretty nice product, but there are some things that I would like to say about it. I went for the default glossy paper. You can see here that it is rather shiny. And I find the color rendition to be particularly great. However, this was not without any defects. As I'm showing you here, there are some white parts that are sitting right behind the acrylic, so there is absolutely nothing that I can do. I contacted Saar Digital for this, and they immediately proposed me two options. Either I reprinted this book, or they offered me another coupon code of the value of this book. I was happy to see that they were willing to do something about this defect. And also there is something that I noticed here, this white kind of bar here. This is not Saar's problem, this is my screw-up, because I did not the proofing well enough. That goes to show that even though there is a reviewing part on the Saar software, if you screw up, you are not really absolutely on your own, but they will not catch everything for you. Overall, I'm pretty satisfied with this product, all but for one thing. The acrylic cover scratches way too easily. I mean, when it arrived, it was pretty much perfect. It was well packaged in cardboard in its foam sleeve, and so I thought I might just transport this book in its foam sleeve. But even with this protection, scratches began to appear. So I waited out a little bit so I could see from transportation to transportation how the acrylic glass would evolve, and the results are not good. I mean, this book costs about 130 euros. That is not something you want to spend every month just because the cover has some scratches. And this cover, it's shiny, it's good looking, etc., etc. But is also the first thing that your potential clients will see. And you really want your cover to be absolutely perfect, especially if you take good care in its transport. So, Sal, if you see this video, please upgrade to a scratch-resistant acrylic so that I will be able to trust my book to withstand a little bit of transportation in its package foam sleeve. This experience with this book makes me afraid of ordering their gallery print product, because if they use the same acrylic as the cover of this book, then I would know for sure that an expensive product would end up being scratched and not very good looking after just a few transportations. That is the minus part of this book. But overall, I'm satisfied, and I even got a refund for this, so I'm quite happy. And with the refund money, I ordered some other products. So here, this is my logo on an aluminum print. I like this because it adds some grain to the picture, even though it was already pretty grainy. And it's a sheet of aluminum on a sheet of plexiglass, and then another sheet of aluminum. On the back side, you have a mount that allows you to sit it on the wall like it's floating against the wall, and I like how it looks. One thing that Sal Digital proposes you is to work with ICC profiles. I had no idea what this was before, and so I did some research on it. And I decided to try out working with the ICC profile here. What is an ICC profile? Well, you know, when you are working the images on your screen, an ICC profile is a way to have a preview of what the image would look on paper, but this preview would be on your screen. And so you end up with something that looks very strange on your screen, like it lacks contrast, etc., etc., because pretty much no paper can match the color contrast of a screen. And so I loaded up the ICC profile and started working colors on this particular product here, on my logo. And what I ended up with is something that is far too red. And why is that? Well, the answer is very simple. This screen here is not calibrated. It's supposed to cover 99% of the sRGB color gamut, but since it's not calibrated, having an ICC profile does not give me an accurate preview. And all the other products that I ordered from Sal, to which I did not use their ICC profiles, ended up being very satisfactory to me. So if you are like me, an absolute beginner, I would just advise, don't bother with the ICC profile thing. Otherwise you will be surprised, just like I was. I ordered another aluminum print. You can see here this mantis that I particularly like. I mean, this was a total surprise to me. I always thought that mantises were kind of exotic insects, and I just stumbled upon one, and it almost looks like a desert, and in fact it's just next to a mall. And I also wanted to try out other products as well, such as a regular canvas. So this is my lotus picture, and it looks kind of meh, in my opinion. I mean, it looks good and all, the colors are great, and the canvas seems resistant enough, but just looks like your average home decoration shop kind of canvas. I don't think I would be able to sell this for a price that would allow me to have some margin. I think I have a much better chance with the aluminium prints. And then I wanted to try out the fine art paper prints. And for the package, something weird happened. I was warned by the postal service that the package needed reinforcement and was badly damaged. And I was like, ah, man, what if anything happened to the paper prints? I mean, any corners, any fold, and it would ruin everything, right? Well, this is what arrived at my day job's office, and I was very, very afraid of what I would discover. I was extremely pleasantly surprised to see that Sal's packaging actually held up, and I ended up with pretty much perfect paper. So yeah, I think that Sal is very good at packaging their products. For my first printing experience, I would say that I'm very satisfied, if I was to say something negative about Sal, would be the lack of humanity. It really feels like you are talking to a machine. Each time you send a mail, a different person responds. When you read their mails, it really feels like a template with names filled in, and so you really do not speak to a human being. And so, if the human element is very important to you, then I would suggest going away from Sal, because you will not get that. Absolutely not. So, to wrap this up, we have a saying in France that goes along the lines of "the grass always looks greener elsewhere." That means we are never quite satisfied with what we have. I must say that for now, Sal's grass looks green enough for me. That doesn't mean I will never go to see another printer. When I started researching about printing photography, photographers say that a picture is not complete until it has been printed. And when I received my first book, it was a very strange and fulfilling kind of feeling, because complete is the word for this. I don't have any words to describe it. It's strange to see that the picture you took is actually in your hands and does look good. So I want to go further into printing. If you have some experience with either online printers or local printers, I would like to hear from you, because I'm an absolute beginner. I only have 6 prints or so. I would like you to share your experience with me so that I can improve. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and see you next time.